Hi friends, in this tutorial we'll be seeing how to call and consume REST API using Apache Camel. So we'll be consuming both GET and POST REST APIs using Apache Camel. For this I'm going to take reference of my website javanews.com. So go to Apache Camel, standalone Apache Camel, examples. And the example that we are going to see today is calling and consuming web services using Apache Camel. I'll be sharing this URL along with the YouTube video. So in previous posts we had seen how to expose REST APIs using Apache Camel. In this tutorial we will be consuming the REST APIs using Apache Camel. So this is the example that we are going to implement. First, using Spring Boot we will be exposing some REST APIs, and then using the Apache Camel route we will be consuming those APIs. So let's begin with the implementation part. So first we will be exposing web services using Spring Boot. So go to Eclipse, create a new Maven project. Create a simple project. We'll give the artifact group ID as com.javanews. The artifact ID will give it as Spring Boot service. Next, we'll be adding the required Maven dependencies. So for these, copy this from here. The dependency that we'll be adding will be the Spring Boot Starter Web dependency. No other dependency is required. Next, we'll be creating the domain class employee. So go to source main Java and create a new class. The package will give it as com.javainuse.model, and the class name will be employee. So copy the employee class content from here. Next, we'll be exposing the REST APIs using the controller class that we'll be writing. So we'll be exposing two APIs here. One will be a GET API, which will accept an ID as a request parameter and create an employee object using the passed ID and return it as a response. The second REST API will be a POST API, which will accept an employee object as a request body, and using the parameters of the passed object it will create another employee object and return it as response. So these are the two APIs that we are going to be exposing. Both will be having slash employee as the URI. So the first is the first service. This takes as ID as the request parameter and then creates an employee object and returns the employee object. The second service, it is also having the URI as slash employee, but this is a POST request. And here it takes the request body as the employee class, and whatever are the parameters of the employee class, using this another new object is created and we are returning that employee as response. So let's create this class. We'll name this as test controller. The package will be com.javanews.controller. Finally, we'll be creating the Spring Boot main class. So this is the Bootstrap class. Package will give it as com.javanews. So we are done with the Spring Boot module that exposes the API. Next, we'll be creating a new module, Apache Camel module, that will be consuming these APIs. So create a simple project. Group ID, just give it as com.javanews, and the name will be giving it as camel-consume API. Next, let us add the required dependencies. So the major dependency that we'll be specifying here will be the Camel HTTP dependency. So using the HTTP component, we'll be calling the services or the APIs exposed by the Spring Boot application and consuming them. So copy the dependency section. Next, we'll be creating the domain class employee. We'll be passing this employee object during the POST request. So let's create this call. Next, we'll be creating a camel processor. The objective of this camel processor will be to create an employee object, marshal it to XML, and then set it as the body for the exchange. So this processor will be called when making a post request to consume the post service. So let's create this class. The package will com.javanews.processor. Next, we'll be creating the simple root builder class. So this is where we'll be defining the routes for consuming the get and the post APIs. So we have written two routes here. One will be consuming the REST API while the other will be consuming the post API. So here we'll get the input in C input folder REST, which will trigger this route. And in the header, we have set the method as HTTP method get. And finally, we have made this call to HTTP localhost 8080 slash employee. And we have passed the request parameter as 5. And also the after this, we are calling another processor, which is my processor. And it does nothing, but it just prints whatever response we are getting after the web service call. Similarly, we have a second route defined here. So this takes input from inbox post. And after this, the route gets triggered. It then calls the create employee processor we have just defined here. So what this does is that in the body, a new employee object is created, marshaled to JSON data format, and then stored in the body. And then we set the header as HTTP method post. Also the content type, we set it as JSON because we are marshaling the body to JSON data. And then we make the web service call to HTTP localhost 8080 slash employee. And again, we'll just be calling another processor named as my processor, which does nothing but just prints whatever response that we are getting. So let's create this class. We'll name this as simple root builder. And the package will be com.javanews.root. Sorry, this will be root. Let's copy the content here. We have still not created the my processor named processor. So this is giving an exception. So let's do that. So in the processor package, create so this is the content of the my processor. This should remove the exceptions. Next, we'll be defining the application context that will be calling our root builder class. So go to source main resources and create a new file. We'll name it as application context.xml. Finally, we'll load the context file to start the Java DSL camel route. So for this, we'll be creating the main app. Package will give it as com.javanews. The application context, we are just giving the application context. So we are done with the changes for the Apache Camel module. So let's test if our application is working properly. So I'll start the Spring Boot application to expose the APIs. Next, start the Apache Camel module. So both our modules have started. Now let's test them. So the route that we have defined here is in the C input folder rest. If anything is added to this folder, this rest call will get triggered and this HTTP call will be made. So for this, we'll copy just a file here. So if you'll see here, we are getting the data here. So a rest call has been made to the controller here, and it is returning us this employee class with the ID that we have passed, which is 5 currently. So our rest call is working properly. Now let us test if the post call is working properly or not. So for this, the route that we have defined is in the C folder, we'll be having inbox post folder. So anything added here, it will make a call to this. So go to this inbox post folder, and here again I'll add here. So here again we'll see that a post call has been made successfully and we are getting this response here. So our both the routes, they are working properly. Hope you have understood this tutorial. The source code for this, it can be downloaded from here.